Learning, of course, has two elements. It could be extrinsic learning or intrinsic. You know, you could have everybody wanting to learn. So, you know, there was a case of a lady called Dorothy, who was 99-year-old, doing a graduate program in social sciences at the age of 99. She went through 6 years and she said, I wanted to just get better at it. Now, and that's purely the intrinsic part which is coming in. Or you would recall many times that, you know, if we were to go and sit in a solitude and read a book, be it novel or be it a book on learning, not that one likes to sit in solitude and read a lot of learning books, but I'll give an example. When I was in school or college, you know, and in our CBSE kind of a learning, it was like you have to learn because you have to clear an exam. But every time before the exam that I would actually start really reading the books and I would say, wow, this is such a fantastic book. Why didn't I read it earlier? You know, and so many years later after schooling, when I read some of the stuff on HR or on technology, and these are things that I help me learn, but these are fantastic. So it's not only novels, but these books as well. And when I sit in the solitude and read that, you realize the enjoyment that you get. That, I think, is the first key element, is the intrinsic motivation. I think I've also realized over a period of time, not everybody has the inherent intrinsic motivation on learning. Then comes the extrinsic one as well, which is to say, okay, what's the role I want? What's the composition I want? Where do I want to go it? So it's not just for a pure pursuit of just learning for learning, but it's also because the learning will enable you to go somewhere. So if I look at that path then, and I think from an organization level, to your question on developing and building a culture, I think there are many things. One is, of course, ensure that the development plans are in place, that everybody has it. We talk it, but many times the discipline is left out, and that is integrated into the career planning of an individual, what an individual does. We recognize the learning. Recognize the learning in many forms. You know, one is, of course, as an individual, when you are creating a certification, you can celebrate it as well. The other important point is also looking at internal people for promotions or job postings that you put in, because then you are saying, oh, hey, Priyanka learned a course and she's exhibited the same on the job and then is ready for a new role. So, you know, the internal environment also says, hey, learning is important because that's how we grow in the organization. Recognizing also people who not only learn but who also teach within the organization, because they are the catalyst in the whole learning process and enabling the learning to actually move up to the next level. So I think that's important. And I think formalizing knowledge sharing. Knowledge sharing, we are all very good at talking, but we struggle to actually then document it and say that, hey, this was an activity which went fantastically well, but let's document and let's see how we can actually progress and take it to the next level. Lastly, I would say the feedback on learning. The feedback, you know, we of course do the smiley sheets feedback very easily, but more than that, also going up the value curve and understanding that how is it really related to a change in the person on the technical side, on the behavioral side, and speaking to the supervisor as well. So there is a change which has taken place and it is continuing. Or also going out to employees and managers to understand as a learning culture how we are doing as an organization, what can we do better. So there are a multitude of this that we use. When I spoke about intrinsic, extrinsic, I also feel that each one of us have different ways of learning. You know, some of us like more fun learning, you know, so that's where gamification has come in. But more than just the word gamification, it's obviously fun learning. You enjoy, you are in the moment, you just enjoy learning. So how do we make that come alive? So I'll also give examples from Ericsson. We do gamification in terms of induction. We call it funduction, where people come in and so they're not listening to Sameer coming and giving a boring lecture, but they actually go around trying to understand, okay, what are the HR policies, click a photo with somebody, understand, go to their workstation and make it more fun based. Similarly, we do in terms of our learning on technical concepts, like if a person has to learn 3G, 4G, 5G, give them scenarios where they're playing a game on the machine and the machine is telling them, hey, you are at this site and you have to create something out of nothing. These are the options. How do you kind of do it? And it's point based. It gets a internal competition. So, you know, one needs to understand what one's learner profiles are and how we can best relate to the learner. What makes him or her tick, and give that for making him or her tick.